Today we are going to have a beautiful and an amazing session. We are going to focus essentially speaking about how you can build a mesmerizing personality, how you can build a charming personality, how you can build a very magnetic and seductive personality that can help you to win in all the circumstances of life. I want you to understand that the 85% of your success in business, in your personal life, will be determined by your ability to communicate effectively with others. Some people call it social intelligence. Social intelligence, or the ability to interact, converse, negotiate with, or persuade others. And I want you to understand that this is one of the most beautiful quality of skills you need to have in your life in order for you to be highly paid and respected. So during this session, we are going to learn stuff that can help you to develop that social intelligence. And the good news is that any one of you watching me can actually develop social intelligence. Social intelligence is something that anyone can develop actually. So you are going to learn how to be warm, how to be friendly, how to be a likable person. You are going to learn how to have the type of personality that will make people to feel comfortable near you, feel like staying around you, doing business with you, hanging around with you. Feel like confidence and safe in your presence. This is one of the greatest secrets of all the great communicators. This is one of the greatest secrets of all the high achievers you see on earth. Your ability to be charming, to be genuinely a likable and a pleasant person can 10x your results, can multiply your success, can open doors for you, can create connection and build a huge network for you. The more people like you, and the more people think that you are a very pleasant person, the more they want to see you. The more they want to see you, and the more they want to listen to you. The more they want to see you, and the more they want to listen to you. The more they like you, the more they want to see you, and the more they want to listen to you, and also the more they want to stay in your presence. Yeah, because you need to like me to feel comfortable in my presence. What is making you to smile in my presence is the fact that you like my personality. There is something about me that you like that is making you to enjoy my presence. So during this session, I'm going to be teaching you how you can build, how you can develop that type of personality that can make people to feel so good around you, to feel so welcome around you. People are going to feel at home each time they come in your presence. So this is a very, very, very interesting session. This is a very, very powerful session. So I want you to pay close attention as I'm going to unfold and present the concept. Are you ready? Okay, let's go. So, why is it so important for me to teach you about stuff like that? Is that if you develop your social intelligence, you'll be more successful. You are going to be more successful. You are going to earn more money. You are going to get promotion even faster in your workplace. If you are in a sales business, you are going to make more sales because people will love to come and buy from you. People will feel so good near you. They will feel like, come and buy stuff from you, on and on and on. And this will give you the ability to be a very powerful and inspirational leader. So the mesmerizing personality, it has all to do with your charming ability. Your charming ability, the ability to make people to like you. The ability to make people to feel comfortable where you. I'm talking about something beyond you look good. I'm not talking about you looking good. No, I'm not talking about you looking sexy or you looking attractive. No. No, no. I'm not talking about you looking good, you dressing good. No, no, no. I'm speaking about something deeper than that. I'm speaking about something very profound, very, very deep. I'm talking about something that goes beyond your physical appearance. It is something that makes people to have such a deep feeling when they are near you. You make them to have memory that they can't forget. When they go back home, they keep thinking about you. Oh my God, that woman is wonderful. That guy is wonderful. Such a nice person. Such a nice woman. So this is the kind of stuff I want to share with you that will enable you to develop a very magnetic personality. So how can you explain that every country I travel, I go in, people are like, oh my God, Wiseman, you are such a nice person. It's not all about the look. It's also about the personality that I develop. The type of personality that I project. When I come near you, there is a way I make people to feel. And this is something that you too watching me, you can actually learn. You can learn it. You can develop it. You can adopt it as a personal lifestyle. Some people choose to do business with me because they like my personality. Some people trusted me with huge amount of money because I develop a likable personality. So they feel like their money is safe with me. They feel like their money is safe with me. I don't know, you can hear me very well? Everybody can hear me very well? If you can hear me very well, drop a comment. If you can hear me very well, drop a comment. If you can hear me very well, just drop a comment to let me know that my sound is perfect. From my side, it's perfect. From my side, it's very perfect. So just check your phone or you check your laptop. Maybe the problem is from your phone or your laptop. So we are talking about how to develop a mesmerizing personality. Something beyond the physical look, the table's manner, the good look, no, the sharp dress or the swag. Something deeper than that. So I want you to get to the point in your life where you made a decision that I'm going to be a charming person. So I'm going to take action to build a charming and a fascinating personality. I'm going to build quality that will make me to be irresistible. I'm going to develop my power to please and my power to attract. That's a charm. Charm is a quality that exerts an irresistible power to please and attract. So if I can develop the ability to please, not to make people to feel in a certain way, no, I'm a pleasant person, and to attract people, what's going to happen to me? This can develop my fame, my success, my sales, and my achievement also in life. There is a level of personality that you develop that makes you to have the power of fascination. So when people look at you, it is like, wow. That's what we are talking about. People look at you, it is like, wow. So everything about you is just like, wow. When you speak, it's wow. When you come in a place, it's wow. When you open your mind, it's wow. Everything you do, people are like, wow, you have a fascinating power. Even if you dress in the simple way, as you go out, it is a wow. So for you to enter into that type of stuff I'm talking about, there are some skills we need to do. There's a way you can do stuff that can make you to be a charming person, that can make you to build a mesmerizing personality. You are going to ask me, but sir, how can I do that? Do you believe that a guy like me can be that attractive, that charming? Yes, I believe. Do you believe that a woman like me can develop that personality? Yes. Even if I'm a mom already? Yes. Even if I'm old? Yes. Even if I'm young? Yes. Oh, yes. I can assure to you without a shadow of a doubt that all of you can develop that personality, and I'm going to show you how. So are you ready? Are you ready? So let's go. So what can I do to develop that type of personality? What can I do? I want you to understand that according to psychologists, the core of personality is self-esteem. Self-esteem can be defined as how much you like yourself. Self-esteem can be defined as how much you like yourself. So your self-esteem is a sum of total of how important, how valuable you feel about yourself at any moment. And human beings are emotional beings. They make decisions based on emotions most of the time. They make decisions based on how they feel. So if you can learn how to master the game of making people to feel in a certain way, you are getting my point already. You are getting my point already. You are going to become, without any effort, charming. So if you can learn how to boast other people's self-esteem, they are going to love you more. They are going to like you more. That's the secret of charm. The deepest craving of a human nature is the need to feel valued or valuable. So if you can make other people to feel important, if you can make them to feel valuable, if you can make them to feel valued, trust me, either they want it or not, they will like you. They will like you. If I can come to you right now, Franceline, and I make you to feel important to me, if I make you to feel special to me, I give you some care, I give you some attention, either you like it or not, you are going to love to spend time with me. If I come to you, Charlene, and I make you to feel important, I give you praise, I give you compliment, you are going to enjoy my presence, because deep within all of us, there is a need to be accepted, to be loved, to feel important, and to feel special. There is nobody on earth who can say, I have all the love that I need. I don't need any love anymore. No. All of us, there is still a room for more love. Because love is something that we can never have enough. Nobody can say, I have so much love already in me, I don't need any love anymore. We will always need more love until we die. So I'm going to show you some ways to be charming. Some ways to be charming. So the key in what I'm talking about is not you making people to feel like you are important. No. The key is you making other people to feel important. So the more you make people feel important in your presence, the more you are going to be charming in their eyes. They are going to perceive you as a wonderful human being because you are able to make them to have some feelings that they are not used to. You are going to make them to have some sensation that they are not used to. So don't come in front of the people and you show to them how big you are. No. Don't come in front of the people and you show to them how amazing you are. No. If you want people to feel that charming power, key number one, acceptance. Acceptance. The greatest gift you can give to other people is the attitude of unconditional positive regard. So that means when you look at other people, you don't judge them. You accept them just as they are. Either they are poor or rich, you just treat them as if you don't care if they are poor or rich. You just treat them good and nice. You just accept them just as they are. You are not there to try to criticize or find fault in them. Do you think you can feel comfortable around someone who is always trying to find faults in you? Even me, I can't feel comfortable. I'm sorry. Some people spend their entire life trying to correct us, trying to find our sins, trying to find our faults, criticizing us for everything we say. But if you learn how to accept other people without judging them, something will happen in their heart. They will feel some positive emotion on the inside. Oh, finally I found somebody who don't judge me based on my house, who don't judge me based on my shoe. You know, sometimes some people want to invite you in their house, but they are ashamed. They say to themselves that, oh, my house is not good. You know, I don't want wise man to see my house. But if I come to your house and I act like there is no problem with your house, you are going to feel so good. Because one of the reasons why some of you don't invite some people in your house, you are thinking, my house is not that good. My house is so bad. My house is so dirty. I'm so poor. I don't want him to see how poor I am. And because of that feeling of our poor, you don't feel that good about yourself. So if somebody comes to you and accepts you just as you are, with your poverty or your wealth, you are going to feel like, wow, that girl is so nice. That boy is so nice. It's just like you're a girl, and you're a poor, very poor girl, and a boy comes to you, is rich, but still he likes you. He don't have nice clothes. You don't have any, makeup, but still, this guy can see your beauty. This guy can see how attractive you are. What will happen to you? You'll be surprised. I don't understand what this guy loves about me. One of the ways he can express that acceptance is looking at you and giving you a smile. When he's smiling at you, you feel something inside. You feel, wow, at least this person appreciates me. And because of that, you are going to develop something. You are going to develop something step by step. That's why it's very, very important for us to develop the gift of acceptance. One of the ways to show that I accept you is that when you come near me, I'm smiling. I look at you, oh, welcome, I'm very happy to see you. That smile makes you to feel welcome. That smile makes you to feel special. That smile makes you to feel important. That smile is telling you, I am happy to see you. And people will find you charming. If you check a lot of people, they will tell you that, oh, I like when wise man smile at me. Yes. Because mostly when I meet people, I give them a smile. They are so happy. They say, oh, sir, I love your smile so much. When you came to my house and you smiled, I was so happy. When you came in my house, you decided to sit down and you smile at us, we were so happy. This is the gift of acceptance. But if I come in your house and I have a very close face, very serious face, you will not feel that comfortable. Maybe this guy is not happy. Maybe this guy is mad at me. Maybe this guy, there's something wrong. What is going on? But if I come to your house and I release the atmosphere with a beautiful smile, you are going to feel comfortable to speak to me. You are going to feel comfortable to smile too. If I look at you and I smile, you feel comfortable to smile back. But if I look at you like this, is it easy to smile? You need to have a very strong self-esteem to send the smile back at me. So the first secret I'm sharing with you is the gift of acceptance. We need to learn how to accept people just as they are. Number two, appreciation. Appreciation. Very, very, very important. You need to learn how to express to others what you feel on the inside. Some people need it. Don't say, oh, he is aware that I'm grateful. She is aware that I love her. She is aware that he is aware as human beings. Whenever you express appreciation to others for something they have done, small, big, or amazing, their self-esteem increase. If I come to you right now and I say thank you because you helped me to find something on the house, or you helped me to do something, and I speak it to you, trust me, you are going to feel something inside. If I come in your house and say, really, I want to say thank you, Chantel. Last time you picked me, I was without you. I don't know. This traffic was amazing. But you came with your car, you picked me, and I was able to go home and say, really, I just came to say thank you for what you did for me last time. Either Chantel like it or not, she will feel like some cold water in the heart. And this is good for health. But most of all, we act like Chantel is in the obligation to do something. We act like Franceline is in obligation. No. Anything you receive from someone, please take time to go and say thank you to people. People will love you more. People will help you more. People will support you more. Most of all, we are losing even good people because we don't appreciate them. We are losing real friends. We take them for granted. We are losing potential husband, potential boyfriend, because we take them for granted. Whatever they do for us, we act like, it's okay, it's okay. He's doing it because he loves me. It's okay, it's okay. No! We need to take a time to say thank you for the person for making so much effort just to show to you how much she loves you. There are some people who love you who will not do so much effort. I am telling you, don't take anything in life for granted. So we need to learn how to take time to go and see people and express what we feel on the inside about what they are doing for us. We are going to raise their self-esteem. We are going to make them to feel better. We are going to make them to feel great. And because we make them to feel like that, trust me, the next time they have the opportunity to help you, they will do. They will feel like this is someone who appreciates my efforts. But if I come and I give you something and you are acting like it was a gift from your dad, well, next time if you have a trouble, you better look for your father. I'm telling you. This is how people are losing stuff. That's the same stuff. If somebody is chatting you, you need to appreciate the fact that some people are chatting you. You know? Because they are people and people. Whatever you don't value, you lose. Whatever you don't appreciate, you lose it. For example, if a guy is coming to visit you, you have a person who always scared to come and visit you, and you never take a time to say thank you or appreciate all the effort, you are going to lose it. You have somebody who is chatting you like me all the time. This is a blessing for you. You need to appreciate it and say thank you. Because there are many people who don't even receive a chat from me. I'm telling you the truth. So when you don't know how to appreciate stuff, you lose it. This is the law of life. So people feel more valuable when you express to them that you love what they are doing, you appreciate what they are doing, because this is going to improve their self-image. This is going to encourage them to do the more because they are aware that you value it. They are aware that you value it. Imagine somebody saying, oh, really? One day, for example, I told Dominga and Baye that, really, I'm seeing everything you are doing for my... I just appreciate what she was doing on my social media, all the sharing and all the stuff. She was so touched. She said, what you just said means so much for me. Yes. This is how we're supposed to live our life. We need to take a pause sometimes and appreciate all the people who are doing something for us. That's why this week I need to travel to Dalaget to go and meet all the people who have been good to me for 1 year. Who have been good to me for 1 year, supporting me for 1 year, standing by me for 1 year. When I go there, I'm just going there to appreciate them. I'm just going there. What we do there, I'm just going to appreciate them. What do you think they are going to feel on the inside? They have friends in their lives. They have been with those friends for years. They never say thank you. And this is somebody who is coming to say thank you for 1 year of real friendship. You know what can happen in their heart? They are going to feel important. They are going to feel somebody loves them. They are going to feel somebody is seeing their effort. They are going to feel somebody appreciate all the fight they are going through because of him. They are going to feel like all their efforts are not in vain. And because of that, because I make them to feel so good about themselves, automatically the way they see me also will increase. Some of you want people to love you so much, you don't even say thank you. You want people to be so good to you, you are not even saying thank you for all the good they have been doing for you. You never took time, even through a gift, or through a text, or through a call, or a face-to-face talk to say, really, I want to say thank you. Thank you for this, thank you for that. Some of you, somebody will even send you money. You can't even send a message to say thank you. No, this is money they send for charity. It's not for me. Why should I say thank you? I'm not the one using it. No! No, no, no. We need to say thank you. We need to say thank you. This is appreciation. This is why some people don't have... This is why some people... Oh, Lord. I'm giving you secrets. Secrets. That thank you can trigger a wonderful feeling inside someone. When you look at someone in the eyes and you say thank you, you don't know what a person can feel. I used to watch my YouTube channel. When I watch the charity videos you are doing, I'm motivated. When I watch those videos and I start hearing people say thank you, some people are crying there. When I watch it, no, even if I say, I don't want to do this stuff anymore. When I watch those videos and I see those thank you, I see those families say, oh, we pray that God can send more people like this guy. When I see people crying on my videos, I see people smiling and shouting, thank you, they are so... When I watch it, either I like it or not, trust me. Even if I come on social media and say, I will never... I know myself. I know myself. Just give me 1 or 2 weeks, you will see me again. Coming like this and sharing money to people. I know myself. I can be mad and say, I don't do this one anymore. I don't help people anymore. No more help. Just give me like 1 week. By the time maybe I watch some videos or I remember 1 or 2 people, I will be the one by my... You will not even call me. I will be the one by myself to wake up and say, come on, post them. Post your GCard, post your... I will be sending money to people like they punish me. Why? Because those thank you can create something in the heart of someone. Those appreciation can make someone to feel like, even if people criticize you for helping, because of this one saying so much thank you, who looks so grateful, I need to continue. So don't underestimate your thank you. Your thank you may be what I need to continue. Your thank you may be what I need to be strong mentally. Maybe I'm saying to myself, why should I keep giving money to people they don't even appreciate? Much better I keep my money and I buy a car. But because I see someone like you who is so grateful, who I feel like I'm not supposed to stop. Because this one means everything for you. So even if 100 people don't appreciate, when I look at that only person who is so grateful, who looks so happy, so blessed by what I'm doing, even if I say I don't want to do anymore, I look at the person, I feel compassion, and I want to continue to do. This is the power of appreciation. I am telling you, don't feel like I don't have anything to give. No, your thank you. Your genuine thank you, your tears of thank you, this is priceless. So learn. Look at the smile on my videos. This is thank you. Look at the smile of the people when you watch my charity videos. Those smiles are thank you. Those smiles mean I'm so happy, sir. Those smile mean, oh, sir, thank you so much. You look big smile, you look the faces shining. You see people jumping, adults jumping, shouting, kids singing, dancing.